morning. We are 3 days away from winning the Republican nomination for the 3rd District here in Kansas, and I could not be more excited to have all of you here with me to do it. Are we ready to win in 3 days?
Yeah!
This has been more about me. It's been less about me. It's been less about all of you. This has been about the district and about the issues. This has been more than just about what we're doing here in this office. It's about the business owners and the families out in the district. It's about all of us wanting to send a message to Washington. What's happening in this country right now is going in the wrong direction. In Washington, we are losing jobs, the economy's hurting, people need support, and what they're getting from Washington is more government spending, more government growth, more regulation, more taxation, and more spending. All of those things make the economy worse. And so what's so great about this movement is it's not just about this office right here, it's not just about all of you, it's about this entire district sending a message to Washington that we do not agree with what's happening with President Obama, Nancy Pelosi, this Congress, and this administration. It's time to send a message to them that we're fed up and we want real change this November, change that we can really believe in right here in Kansas City. So who's with me for that? This campaign we've been waging since about December when we started things, and it's been a very exciting experience to have all of you on board. We've knocked on 20,000 or more doors, we've put up 5,000 or more yard signs, we've got TV ads, some of you have been in TV ads that are here. We are taking auditions later for Yoder Voter commercials, if you guys have been practicing. We've had some great success and an amazing, amazing amount of support from people all across the district. And all that hard work over those last six, seven, and eight months comes to fruition in the next 3 days when voters go to the polls here in the 3rd District. And first of all, I want to thank all of you for all that time and sweat and money and friendship and advocacy, because everything you've done has put wind behind our sails and put us where we are today. We would not be here today without all of you in this room. So I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart for believing in me and believing in our message and having the strength and courage to stand up for us and support our team. So thank you so much for doing that for us. I'd love to introduce, we do have a couple elected officials. Representative Marvin Kleb is here this morning. Marvin, thanks for coming. Also, the Shawnee Mission School Board, Larry Wynn is here. Former State Representative Dean Newt is here. Dean. And all of you are community leaders in your own way. And I've been so pleased in this campaign because not only have we had a strong group of support, we've had really, really good, great people supporting our campaign. I've built so many friendships with so many folks in this campaign that I just feel so blessed to have all of you in our lives. Brooke and I are just so pleased in this campaign. Brooke's here this morning, and Brooke, you received a message from Brooke last night on your phone. Got a personal call from Brooke. We just have been so pleased to have your friendship and support. We've got a lot of work to do the next 3 days to win this campaign. August 3rd, the primary on Tuesday, the polls close at 7 p.m., and there's a lot of work to do between now and 7 p.m. You can see our countdown here, over here on the wall, 3 days, 8 hours, and 35 minutes. We've been going strong now for, I don't know how many months that calendar's been up there, and I've just watched it count down and down and down. We've got it counted down to the final hours. And so I need your help over these next few days to get our vote out. This election is by no means in the bag. Do we have this thing won. We have to go out and win it. We're like a football team that's practiced hard, and now we've got the big game on Tuesday. We know the fundamentals. We have the resources. We have the talent. Now we just have to put our team on the field and win. And so anything you can do over the next few days to help us get there will get the job done and make a huge difference in this campaign. Don't feel like your 10 minutes of calling or an hour here on these phones or knocking on doors in your neighborhood or even just sending an email to your friends and family reminding them to vote doesn't make a huge difference. Secretary of State reported the other day that there's going to be about a 19% turnout in Kansas. That means 4 out of every 5 Republicans that we know aren't going to vote in this election. That means if you can get just a few of them to vote and vote in our column, it makes a huge difference. Their votes mean even that much more. And so everything you can do, every time, every ounce of energy you can put in over the next few days will help us get to where we need to be. We have a great staff, by the way, and Travis is going to address you here in a little bit. Travis is our campaign manager. We've had an amazing experience of young people get involved in this campaign. And traditionally, you think maybe young folks get involved with the Democratic Party, or they don't get strongly involved in behind the Republicans. But I will tell you, I've been so pleased to have a lot of young college students believe in what we're doing and get involved because they want to change what's happening in Washington. When you talk about a $13 trillion debt that every college student coming out of college is going to have to pay, that's a big concern for folks. And so this election is not just about us today, it's about the future. And it's about where we're going as a country and whether we believe that borrowing from our grandchildren, that taxing and spending is the way to get to prosperity. I know I don't believe that, and I know you don't believe that. And we're going to take that very positive, responsible, fiscally conservative message to the voters in this election, not only for the next 3 days, but through the next 90 days, as we talk to voters about what they want in this election. And do they want the Nancy Pelosi set of economic policies that grow government, that support increased regulation and taxation, or do they want free market and free enterprise and belief in the individual and belief in the small business owner that's the backbone of this economy in this country? That's what I believe in. I know that's what you believe in, and I know that's where this country believes, and we've got to wake them up, let them know what's going on in this country, get them to the polls, and win this election, and send a true message to Washington. Who's with me to do that? Travis, who welcomed you this morning. Travis is our campaign manager, and Travis is going to kind of tell you a little bit about what we're up to in the last few days.
Thanks, Kevin. Well, I'm sure you've all guessed by now that we didn't just invite you over for coffee and donuts this morning, although we hope you... Where's Nancy? Nancy Stark? Nancy, thank you so much for providing the goodies for us. They're wonderful. But yeah, please do... The goal here this morning is that we can get you all plugged in some form or another. We have a great phone bank right here, and if you haven't tried it, I would encourage you to spend an hour or two on the phones this morning. It's really cool. You'll be able to make approximately 60, 70, 80 calls an hour with this high-tech phone system. So we have a couple of things. One, phones, two, doors, and the third ask for you this morning is on election night. We will ask for an hour of your time from about 6:30 to 7:30, if you can give it to us. So let me start back up and start with one. If you're willing to help us this morning just for a couple of hours, please come right after I'm done speaking, and we'll give you a tutorial all at once. It's easier if we just explain it as a group. Over here on these phones, right after we're done speaking. Cool system, you'll love it. If you're not into talking on the phone, we'd love to send you out door to door. We've got walk sheets. Most of you have probably already done this. We'll meet just over in this corner and do another tutorial after I'm done speaking. And the third, on election night, if you're willing to report poll results, please talk to Eric Voss, tall guy right there. He'll take your name and info and get you plugged in. What we're going to have you do is show up at your poll about 6:30, 6:45, wait till it closes down. You'll get a poll worker authorization form. You'll report back the numbers to us over here at the Marriott on Tuesday night. So those are our three big asks. We're going to be working through voter contact for the next 3 days and 8 hours, almost nonstop. So if you can't work this morning, we'll plug you in later tonight, or even tomorrow after church starting around 12:30. And all day Monday and all day Tuesday, we will be here. So if you've got a lunch break for an hour or so on Monday or Tuesday, please come in. We'd love to get you plugged in. The reason that we are all doing this is because the data show that we can influence this election in a primary election like this up to 6% by what we do starting right now through Election Day. So we don't want to miss that opportunity to have a huge impact. So just the phone calls and the doors that we knock and call through Tuesday afternoon could influence this election up to 6%. And so just so you have it in your minds what we're all getting at here. So thank you again so much for coming. We all really appreciate your effort. Some of you have been with us from day one and a lot of new faces this morning. But with that being said, we'd love to talk to you either over in the corner here about doors or right here about phones or with Eric about Tuesday night. Thank you all very much. Thank you.